Welcome back to Vegas, NetApp Insights 2025. I'm Christoph Bertrand, Principal Analyst with Acube Research, and we are going to be talking a little bit about cloud. I have two great guests. I have Pravjit, Tiwana, your SVP and GM of the Cloud Storage and Services business. Not a small job. And another interesting speaker, Ashish, Dhawan, and your SVP and GM and CRO for the Cloud Business Unit. So absolutely at the heart of what's going on with the cloud business at NetApp. Look, it was a great keynote. I heard a lot of very interesting things. And I'm going to start with you, Pravjit, and I'm curious about what your take is on the announcements today. I mean, I heard hyperscaler neutrality. I heard we'll talk about the cloud volumes for Google Cloud. Let's talk about that. What's your take on the announcements?
No, like, if you see, our journey started in cloud almost 8-10 years back, right? Like, but in the last 12 to 18 months, we have really amped up not only just in terms of capabilities which we are bringing to our customers, but also the usage of our cloud storage services. So if you look into the announcements which were made at the keynote today, there are a few which really stand out in terms of themes of what we are doing. The first one is like what George and Sham also spoke about, is to bring AI to the data. So we are one of the uniquely differentiated storage services out there where we are natively integrated into each of the three hyperscalers, AI and analytics stacks, be it Bedrock and Q in Amazon, or Azure AI and analytics services, or Gemini Enterprise on Google. The point being, right, like with our capabilities like SnapMirror and FlexCache, you never have to move the data out. You can bring your AI and analytics right to where the data is. Then the second aspect of that theme is also about, right, our customers love that for their workloads, they have a multi-protocol support. So they have both file and block capabilities enabled from a single place, right? Like, so they don't have to use different vendors for different things. In continuation of that ask from our customers, we have specifically now have not just file storage in each of our hyperscaler, but we also have block storage available in our other hyperscalers. Yes. That was one of the other great news which we shared today in the keynote about was the GCNB block. We already have it at FSx and on. So that is the second theme of it is. And third is, right, like while AI is definitely driving a lot of innovation, but we are laser focused on workloads like SAP, EDA, HPC, VMware, and so on, right? So if you see, even for EDA kind of workloads, Microsoft, Amazon, their internal chip design systems are also using our cloud storage services available there. So we are bringing lots and lots of capabilities on that. And the couple other small things which are, or not small things, but really attractive things which are very close to me are, the first one is, right, like we are enabling the persona of developers to use our cloud storage services.
Right.
So we also announced, right, like Visual Studio Code extensions where developers can use chat-like interface to start using our cloud storage services. And also, we announced NetApp Data Migrator, which is basically a free capability with high security and less error, or zero error aspirations to migrate your NFS and SMB data over from any clouds, any storage system over to our cloud storage. So in all, some of all these capabilities were driven working backward from the customer ask, and we're very, very excited about how they're being received by our customers.
Right, and there are many customers here today, and we had some great customer examples as well during the keynote. So I was very interested in what you described because it's actually extremely comprehensive. More importantly, if you take a step back, what it does, it really talks to unification and sort of freedom of choice. So pick your cloud, pick your partner, we're going to work with it, we're going to give you the same experience and allow you to move from one to the other and build your data platform, which is the big term that was used today, and all of that with ONTAP and NetApp at the heart of it, on-prem and the cloud hybrid. I'd like to double click on what you mentioned, the Google cloud volumes for NetApp, or did I say the GCNV, did I say
yes.
It correctly? I almost did not use the acronym, but we're in tech, we love acronyms. So actually, I'm going to ask you, Ashish, to tell us more about it and what your take is on the introduction and what you expect it to do from a business perspective. You spend, I imagine, a lot of your time, if not most of your time, with clients, with customers. How critical is it that you've just announced this?
GCNV or Google Cloud NetApp Volumes is one of the most performant storage services within the Google platform, Google Cloud platform. Now, with this announcement that GCNV will support the block protocol, it gives the customers the freedom to look at GCNV as the storage service of choice without worrying whether the protocol used is file storage or block storage. I remember one of my customers telling me that they love the solutions from NetApp because of the unified storage platform that we had. In fact, one customer said, hey, I feel like Henry Ford. I've given my team members the choice that you should use any storage platform as long as it's NetApp. The reason is unified storage. You never have to worry about protocol conversions, yeah. Worry about this workload is for file, this other workload is for block. It also gives the customers the freedom to plan their future. Also gives the customers to look at workloads which are cross data center, like VMware, which inherently have both file and block workloads,
right?
And they can then therefore use this to migrate the entire data center, right? So again, the name, the real benefit is freedom. The real benefit is choice. And they are able to plan their future focused on the workloads rather than focused on minutiae like protocol conversions, et cetera.
So let me continue with you, Ashish, because you brought up a customer that you spoke with. If you think about all of your customers, you're dealing with a variety of customers across the board here. How do you expect them to respond and react to these announcements that you heard today for cloud and beyond?
I think, the customers are looking at a partner to migrate their most critical workloads, right? They're looking at, hey, we need somebody who first helps us migrate. And then once we've done the migration, the customers want a partner that can then utilize the migrated data for AI outcomes. With GCNV now becoming a unified storage platform, it becomes a single platform that can be used for migrating their most critical workloads, like VMware, like SAP, and many other workloads, as well as becoming that data pipeline, like Pravjit said, that data pipeline to use things like Gemini Enterprise, right, which they want to use for their AI outcomes, right? So imagine this. This becomes now the single service for both migration and AI work. That's powerful. And the customers are going to respond very well. We've already spoken with many of them during the initial stages, and they're very excited about this launch.
Right, and it really changes in many ways the traditional use cases that you would have seen even a few years ago. I did start in this business when it was, yes, cloud and file was very different worlds. Definitely, and an object came up. So definitely we're in a different world now. I think AI is bringing it together. But I want to come back to a couple of comments you both made on other workloads, not just AI, because let's talk about what I will colloquially say, what's on the truck. I mean, today, your customers are managing SAPs, they're managing a number of transactional environments and applications and a bunch of other things, and virtual environments, et cetera. So beyond AI, and I'm going to turn to you, Pravjit, on this one, what other workloads would you like to highlight to run the show, run the business?
No, you are right. Like AI, though, is one of our futuristic and transformative workloads. But we are not taking our eyes off the workloads which has been running on-prem and cloud storage for decades, right? And where we shine in those is, right, like if you see over the last 30 years, we have built a lot of differentiated features and capabilities in our cloud storage, in our storage portfolio via ONTAP, right? Like be it around security, be it around performance, be it around throughput, be it around data management capabilities, especially the capabilities like SnapMirror or FlexCache or snapshotting or thin clones, right? We are bringing all those ONTAP capabilities into the cloud. Where we are seeing more and more usage from our customers is especially around the workloads which you were referring to, especially, right? Like EDA and HPC is one of our hero workloads. Same as VMware and databases, right? And GenFile will always be there. So while we are transforming our cloud storage offerings into be more and more AI ready, but this doesn't mean that, hey, we are slowing down our pace or the capabilities which we are building for our traditional workloads as less. So it will be a healthy mix, more and more healthy mix going forward.
Yes, and I was going to ask you, Ashish, in closing, how do you see the AI infrastructure evolving, especially in the context of Gen AI and the, sort of the intense resources that are needed? What are your customers telling you they want to do next?
I think, so customers are very clear. They don't want to create their own models anymore, right? The frontier models that are there, which are hosted on each of the hyperscalers, are getting to a parameter level that they are so good that they don't need to create their own models. At the same time, they also want to make sure that they utilize their own enterprise data for RAG and inferencing. And I think for that, the infrastructure setup is exactly what NetApp is trying to build. We want to make sure that for RAG and inferencing, they are able to connect to the hyperscalers with the data pipelines that we are building. They're able to utilize the platforms like Amazon Bedrock, like Gemini Enterprise and Google Vertex AI, like Microsoft Foundry, using our own first-party cloud services, and then have the power of the enterprise data deliver the enterprise AI outcomes that they want. That's powerful, because up until now, they were getting AI outcomes only for a small part of their data estate. Their data was so disparate that they would not be able to get the entire outcome, which is an inferencing outcome. We're helping them build the infrastructure to get enterprise AI from their entire estate. That's unique, that's differentiated, and I think that'll help them in getting what they want in the future as well.
Well, thank you very much, Ashish. Pravjit, thank you also for your comments. Great announcements, lots of great work for you guys in the cloud space, and thank you so much for sharing this with us here on theCUBE.
Thank you.
Thank you. And to our viewers, stay tuned. Christoph Bertrand, Principal Analyst here at theCUBE Research. We'll be back at NetApp 2025 here.